knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave explains.
For many tutorials, we have been examining every single phylum in the animal kingdom, and at this point, we have covered almost all of them. Going through the clade Protostomia took quite some time, and by comparison, Deuterostomia, the only clade we have left, might seem like a breeze in comparison, given that it contains only three phyla. But this clade contains the phylum Chordata, which houses the majority of the common animals we are most familiar with, so that will take quite a lot of time as well. But before we dive into any specifics, let's discuss some general information regarding deuterostomes. All deuterostomes are members of bilateria and nephrozoa, meaning they are all bilaterally symmetrical triploblasts. Again, this clade contains just three phyla with varying body types, those being Hemichordata, the acorn worms, Echinodermata, which includes the sea stars, sea cucumbers, and others, and Chordata, which includes Cephalochordata, Tunicata, and Vertebrata. All these phyla evolved from bilaterally symmetrical ancestors, which demonstrated bilateral symmetry at some point in their lives. Though some deuterostomes, like the vertebrates, are always bilaterally symmetrical, others, like the echinoderms, produce larvae that are bilaterally symmetrical, whereas the adults are radially symmetrical. They are also all triploblasts, which means that during gastrulation, an early stage in embryonic development where the blastula reorganizes into a multi-layered gastrula, there are three germ layers, which are primary layers of cells. These layers are the ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. The ectoderm is the outermost layer of cells, which differentiate to form epithelial and neural tissues, such as the skin, hair, brain, and spinal cord. The mesoderm is the middle layer, which differentiates to become a wide range of tissues, from the muscles to red blood cells and parts of the gonads. By mass, it will make up most of the adult body. Finally, the endoderm is the inside layer, which will develop into the interior linings of the digestive and respiratory tubes. But as we know, the characteristics of triploblasty and bilateral symmetry apply to all members of nephrozoa. What sets deuterostomes apart from protostomes are further differences in their embryonic development. While both clades share a common ancestor, their embryonic development diverges early on, leading to distinct characteristics in adult animals. In the protostomes, during the process of gastrulation, the blastopore, which is an inward folding of cells, will, after development, become the mouth. Meanwhile, in the deuterostomes, this inward folding will become the anus. The term protostome comes from the Greek word protostoma, meaning first mouth, whereas the term deuterostome essentially translates to second mouth. So in protostomes, during the process of gastrulation, the mouth forms before the anus. Meanwhile, in the deuterostomes, the anus forms before the mouth. Numerous studies have confirmed that Deuterostomia is a monophyletic clade, meaning that it includes all descendants of a common ancestor. The deuterostome fossil record is indeed rich, and multiple lineages were already present in the early Cambrian, including early echinoderms, hemichordates, tunicates, and vertebrates. There are also a number of extinct groups, such as the Vetulicolians, which lacked appendages of any kind, and their relationship within the deuterostomes is still debated. Other deuterostome lineages, especially the vertebrates, are well documented in the fossil record due to their evolution of mineralized skeletons, which can be preserved for hundreds of millions of years. Some of the oldest chordate fossils, for example, date back over 500 million years, and their diversity exploded in the Paleozoic, most notably with the armored ostracoderms. With all of this understood, it remains the case that there are three extant phyla within deuterostomes: the echinoderms, the hemichordates, and the chordates. We will save chordates for last, since it's such a diverse clade. For now, we can begin by examining the hemichordates, so let's move forward and check out the acorn worms.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.